Hello, one and all. Welcome to this edition of Kitz Corner. I hope you're having a fantastic day so far. So Nancy Pelosi was met with a disturbance. As you know, the Democratic Party still continues on slush funding their money, our resources, our military expertise, the CIA, hijacking our Federal Reserve to sending it to their slush fund of the military-industrial complex to continue on this manufactured war where we're using Ukraine as cannon fodder to fight against Russia. To use the quote of Adam Schiff, we're using this to fight Russia over there so we don't have to fight them over here. And of course, Nancy Pelosi, being the former House Speaker of the Democratic Party, now stepping down because Kevin McCarthy took over and they lost a bunch of seats because the Democratic Party couldn't rail against the Republican Party because the Republican Party at least had something. The Democratic Party didn't resist anything. And because we live in a corporate duopoly, we live in a one-party system, the corporate party, there's no way to vote out against war. There's no way to vote against about anything. There's no way to vote out against Wall Street. And the fact that people of the Republican Party were able to hold members of their own party accountable and get something in return for withholding their vote, which is something that we hoped AOC would accomplish but didn't, or hoped that Bernie would accomplish but didn't, and that's why they're complete sellouts. Nancy Pelosi was met by a disturbance in San Francisco when a bunch of people schooled her on the horrible policies that she has endowed before leaving office. And some of the things just are common things that any person would probably say right to her face. I'd probably say a lot more things, but I mean, there are, I guess, more pleasant people. But here's what they had to say about this, and watch this. So it says, Justin, Nancy Pelosi gets heckled in San Francisco over U.S. giving Ukraine billions of dollars. Billions of dollars. As we're experiencing a homeless crisis, inflation skyrocketing, people can't afford their heat, people can't afford gas, they can't afford to put food on the table. We're sending a bunch of millions of dollars and billions of dollars from the Federal Reserve off to a corrupted nation in Eastern Europe. So here's what went down.
Let me just get you to
Nancy, can you tell us why we have all the $150 billion going to Ukraine? We have homeless on the streets in your own city. Nancy, can I get some stock trading tips on how to get semiconductors in Taiwan? Nancy, is your son involved with Hunter Biden?
Ah! That was funny. Okay, let me play this again. It's a short clip, but it is definitely hilarious.
Let me just get you to
Nancy, can you tell us why we have all the $150 billion going to Ukraine? We have homeless on the streets in your own city. Nancy, can I get some stock trading tips on how to get semiconductors in Taiwan? Nancy, is your son involved with Hunter Biden?
It's funny because it's exactly true. And people know better. And people are schooling Nancy Pelosi on exactly what she's doing. Exactly what she did. She sent a bunch of money to a corrupted nation in Eastern Europe, funding neo-Nazis, funding the war machine to manufacture war against Russia. That's one of the things that she's done. She also went to Taiwan because we need to defend Taiwan. The only reason we're even mentioning Taiwan is exactly what that guy said. It's because there's stock trade in Taiwan when it comes to conductors. That's the only reason Taiwan's even mentioned by these politicians. The only reason Nancy Pelosi would have no idea where the country was if it wasn't for stock trading. Which is why we got to defend them from the evil China. You know, that country where we send all of our manufacturing jobs. That country where it provides 99% of our manufactured goods. Yeah, the nefarious bastards they are. If only there were some people out there that would stop these corporations from fleeing the country and going to another country to exploit those people at a cheaper price. If only could someone could hold corporations accountable. But that's not in the world of politics, in the world of Democrats, and in the world of Republicans. That's nowhere the case. Nowhere the case. And then also, is her son having business ties with Hunter Biden? That's hilarious. That's hilarious. I also want to play it again. One more time. Because it's just absolutely amazing.
Let me just get you to
Nancy, can you tell us why we have all the $150 billion going to Ukraine? We have homeless on the streets in your own city. Thank you. Nancy, can I get some stock trading tips on how to get semiconductors in Taiwan? Nancy, why do we? Is your son involved with Hunter Biden?
And she's just smiling there. She's just sitting there, like smiling, like. I was going to order some ice cream and then you ruined it. Just with a cringe face smile. Like, just sitting there like that. Drinking a cocktail at a restaurant while this guy is making accurate points. Very, very accurate points. Holding your career accountable as a fundraiser for the Democratic Party. Let's not forget that. She's a fundraiser who got rid of Paygo to get rid of progressive politics and to get rid of actual policies that would help people, because it ain't sexy. It ain't sexy, according to the Young Turks and a Kasperian. Because she defends people like Nancy Pelosi. She'll defend people like Madeleine Albright, you know. It ain't sexy to call out war criminals. It ain't sexy to call out people who advocate for torture. It ain't sexy to call out Wall Street crooks like her. And he's not wrong. He's not wrong because, as we know, according to the Washington Examiner, the U.S. aid to Ukraine tops $112 billion. In first year, as Biden promises more to come. $112 billion. So, to anyone, let me just say this. To anyone who says that Medicare for all, we can't afford it. We can't afford good schools. We can't afford infrastructure. We can't afford, where's the money going to come from? I want you to shove it. I want you to take this article and shove it up your ass. Because if we can give $112 billion like that to another country, why in the hell can we not afford to invest it into our own goddamn people? And it would actually be an investment, because when you have healthier, smarter, safer, better off people, they become more productive and your economy does better. But we're going to send it to a bunch of neo-Nazis so we can go kill each other in another country. Because we care so much about humanity. We care so much about life. $112 billion of slaughter funds. And as Jimmy Dore pointed out in that anti-war rally, if anyone watched, that $100 billion could have went to so many things. So many things. And I want to show people this again, because this montage highlights everything. This montage highlights so much of the fact that we live in a completely corrupted dystopian empire that's collapsing within itself. Because we are extending our military so much elsewhere that inside our own grounds is completely corroded and falling apart and falling within the cracks.
Congress taking quick action, approving a $13 billion deal.
Significant increases in children that are homeless.
Another $800 million to further augment Ukraine.
A revealing look at homelessness among the middle class.
U.S. have announced new military assistance for Ukraine. They promised an extra $713 million.
A 22% increase in homelessness.
A new $40 billion Ukraine aid bill.
The homeless problem we are seeing in Knoxville is growing at an alarming rate.
An additional $700 million.
We don't know where we're going to go. We have no savings.
The U.S. sending an additional $1 billion.
The CEO of the Coalition for the Homeless of Central Florida tells me this is a scary trend.
It's sending a new $450 million military package.
The issue of homelessness, of course, a growing problem here in Colorado.
The U.S. sending an additional $400 million.
Rising housing costs and inflation are leading to more people living on the street.
The United States is sending another $1 billion in military aid. The homeless crisis continues to grow at an alarming rate.
A new aid package is going to be announced tomorrow, including an additional $3 billion.
The number of homeless people in Southern California is on the rise.
White House now asking Congress for more than $13 billion.
69,000. That's how many people are homeless across L.A. County.
Biden administration preparing to send another $600 million military package.
Sacramento's homeless population had a jump of 67%.
Included in the $1.1 billion package are 18 HIMAR launchers.
More than 2,500 students within the district don't have a place to call home.
$725 million.
A record number of families out on the street.
$275 million.
Close now to declaring a state of emergency over homelessness.
$400 million in additional security assistance.
And you can see the fallout of that just right behind me here.
$37.7 billion.
Ryan is one of the more than 3,000 chronically homeless people in Portland.
A $275 million aid package.
The state had the largest rate of increase in its homeless population in the country.
Nearly $45 billion.
A stunning change in the price of home.
Over $3 billion in new military assistance.
The number of people living on the streets reached a record high. The
U.S. unveils a $2.5 billion military assistance package.
The city hit a record number of homeless deaths in 2022.
It makes you wonder how many boxes of rice-a-roni it would take to equal the same cost as one military missile. It makes you wonder how many pounds of rice it would cost. How many bags of rice it would equal to the amount to buy a tank. How much it would cost. How many tiny houses that we can build that would be the same cost as giving funding to Ukraine military. Don't tell me this is about humanity. Don't tell me this is about, you know, life and we care about people. That is over. That is completely goddamn over. Because that is the propaganda garbage you hear about every single war. And while we're still trying to pay off the last few wars that we manufactured and grotesquely invaded countries and killing off by the millions, we're just continuing on more war. Because apparently that's the answer to everything. When you're finished a war and you can't pay it off, you go to another war. It's like credit cards, right? You can't pay off the one credit card, so you might as well apply for another one. Meanwhile, we're still in debt. We have a homelessness crisis. We have absolutely high inflation. We have shortages. We have people that are living under streets and bridges and all across America. And kids, young kids, are at a higher homelessness rate right now because of this. $112 billion. We could have everything. We could have the perfect society. With $112 billion, we can have a perfect society with great health care, amazing education, infrastructure, jobs program, living wages. We can have the best damn economy in the God-given earth if we didn't do this. But this is how grotesquely evil, sociopathic the Democrats, the Republicans, the entire war duopoly. How they would spend billions and billions of dollars to slaughter us, that instead of billions and billions of dollars to invest in us. They don't give two shits about you. And that's why we need to rage against the war machine.